mass gatherings of 50 or more people banned in Dane County, the unprecedented steps officials are taking in our area. And UW-Madison students are heading home for break, uncertain about when they'll be back. Plus chaos in airports across the country with more travel restrictions potentially on the way.
This is News 3 Now at 10.
This is going to be a long-term thing. This is not something that will be over in a week or two. This is something that our community is going to be working on for months, if not years.
Thanks for joining News 3 Now at 10. I'm Amanda Quintana. Madison and Dane County leaders are implementing new rules tonight, banning mass gatherings of more than 50 people to help prevent the spread of coronavirus. Restaurants and other businesses must reduce their seating capacity by 50%. Officials say it will take collaboration from the entire community to prevent the spread.
If they choose to go out, or they need to go out into the community, is to practice aggressive social distancing. And so if you are choose to go to a restaurant, you need to be 6 feet away from the next party, whether that's sitting at a table or that's standing in line or waiting outside, right? We all need to come together and help each other through this.
County Executive Joe Parisi says younger people may not be as susceptible to the disease compared to people with compromised immune systems, but they can still act as vectors who spread the disease to potentially vulnerable groups. New tonight, the CDC is making a similar recommendation nationwide. Officials are calling for the cancellation of in-person events of 50 or more people for the next 8 weeks. The agency's new guidelines were issued to governors earlier tonight. For more on how this new order will impact businesses in our community, we turn it over to our Jamie Perez. Jamie.
Well, grocery stores are exempt from that rule, but places like restaurants will definitely be feeling that impact. And this is already a struggle for restaurants right now who are not seeing very many people coming out to eat. But one restaurant owner that I spoke with wants to remind all of us that we are all dealing with hardships right now and that we will all get through this together.
We are going to get through this, and we're going to get through this together.
Mayor Satya Rose Conway and other Madison public officials announced earlier today that restaurants will be restricted on the amount of customers that are allowed inside, stating all restaurants will reduce to half capacity.
And we are relying on the public to take this seriously and to social distance all the time.
Restaurant owners like Dave Heidi have taken a huge hit in business in the past few weeks. That, on top of this already being a slow time of the year. But he's trying to bring some light into this situation by doing what he does best.
So Liliana's and Charlie's, it's $5 for a bowl of soup to help warm you up. You can get as many as you want. And then you can also, if you want, pay nothing or pay a dollar. You can pay whatever amount feels right for you.
Every day, he has been making about 40 quarts of soup at his restaurants and offering curbside pickup, takeout at a pay-what-you-can price to help those with food insecurities and those who need some warm, hearty soup to comfort them. You can call ahead to order online or even donate to help others take home a bowl of soup that don't have the means to pay for it. And he says he's doing this until Disney opens their parks back up.
That's our thing. If Disney's closed, we got to bring some happiness. As soon as Disney reopens, then we might be done, but we may still continue. I don't know.
As a way to help during this stressful time for all of us, he's taking the first step to making this negative situation into a positive.
I think it's really good to like take things seriously, but I also think something that's really important is to have a little bit of hope. And I think that's another reason for the soup. It's just a way to say like, hey, maybe there's still some good stuff out there. Maybe there's some stuff to look forward to. Maybe it's not the worst thing to ever happen in the world. Maybe it's all going to be okay.
I have information on how you can get a bowl of soup at one of his restaurants online. Dave Heidi also said that he and many others in the restaurant business are prepared for a very difficult next couple of weeks or months financially, and that if he has to, he will turn both of his restaurants into pay-what-you-can models and do takeout only. Now, here's a couple of other ways that you can help struggling businesses and restaurants right now. Shop or order online. This gives businesses a way to keep their business going. Order takeout at restaurants so that even if you aren't comfortable sitting down to eat, you aren't hurting your favorite places financially. And if you do go out, make sure you tip well. It could make up for at least a little of the difference of the people who are not going out to eat right now.
Jamie, thank you so much. With the new order, school districts throughout the area say they will be closing school immediately in an effort to prevent the virus's spread. Madison, Sun Prairie, Verona, and Janesville join more than 50 other districts in our area that will be closed until at least April 3rd. You can find a full list of school closures on our website, channel3000.com. Many UW-Madison students are still heading home tonight, but some are choosing to stay on campus. One UW student and New York native says he chose to stay because it's risky to go back to his home state, which has among the highest number of confirmed coronavirus cases in the U.S.
It's definitely scary stuff. I mean, with all your friends moving out of the dorms, it's been a pretty emotional couple of days. But mostly, I feel like as soon as this blows over, things will just return to normal. That's what I'm hoping.
In addition to the residence halls, the university's libraries will remain open, with the school moving all instruction online. Zhang says he plans to spend most of his time doing homework. The UW has plans to keep classes online at least through April 10th, with the decision about returning to campus being made later next month. Madison College is closing all facilities tomorrow morning until at least March 29th. Classes and activities scheduled from March 23rd through the 29th are now canceled. The college says it's planning alternative ways of teaching that don't require face-to-face instruction beginning March 30th. Let's check your first one forecast with meteorologist Dina Fulton.
Overall, we're expecting another quiet night. We had some clouds starting to build in later this evening, but they're staying quiet on our Doppler radar at this time. Temperature-wise, we're sitting close to 32 in Madison, and we're expecting those temperatures to fall a few more degrees with that cloud deck building in overhead. We'll land in the upper 20s for our overnight lows, so pretty seasonable night ahead. Tomorrow, variably cloudy skies, but milder temperatures for your work week. We will take a closer look at a full forecast in just a few minutes.
Thank you, Dana. The Federal Reserve is cutting interest rates to zero. The last time the prime rate was this low was during the global recession more than a decade ago. The Fed says it will purchase $700 billion of Treasury bonds and mortgage-backed securities. The Fed could take rates into negative territory in the coming days, but Chairman Jerome Powell has resisted that idea. Meanwhile, the president's coronavirus task force says a new website will soon be available for the public to learn where and when they should be tested. In the meantime, the White House is calling on all Americans to do even more to isolate themselves and prevent the spread of the virus.
Myself, personally, I wouldn't go to a restaurant. I just wouldn't, because I don't want to be in a crowded place. I have an important job to do. I don't want to be in a situation where I'm going to be all of a sudden self-isolating for 14 days.
The White House and Congress are working on a potential stimulus to help businesses survive the pandemic. There's still chaos at airports dealing with a surge of people coming back from Europe after new travel restrictions went into effect Friday. As Chris Van Cleef reports, the Trump administration says it has not ruled out the possibility of domestic restrictions too.
Pandemic panic at some of the nation's biggest airports as new travel restrictions caused long lines to clear customs for people returning from Europe. The hours-long wait times in Dallas, New York, and Chicago, packing huge crowds into tight spaces, exactly the kind of gathering Americans are being told to avoid. The delay appears to be a mix of staffing, the mandatory health screenings, and newly implemented declaration forms that caught travelers by surprise.
We just got an in-flight notification that something must have changed in the 10 hours of our flight, because Border Patrol is going to come onto our plane and have us fill out a lot of health forms.
President Trump tweeting Sunday, "We are doing very precise medical screenings at our airports. Pardon the interruptions and delays. We are moving as quickly as possible." Illinois' governor blasted the federal government's efforts.
"Today, it's going to be even worse. There are a larger number of flights with more people coming, and they seem completely unprepared."
The growing list of travel restrictions in China and Europe come as the airline industry is in free fall. Delta is slashing capacity by 40% and grounding 300 airplanes in the coming months. American Airlines announced it's cutting 75% of its international flying and will park or retire most of its long-haul fleet. The world's four biggest cruise lines are suspending U.S. cruises for a month, an unprecedented shutdown of a $38 billion industry.
The next round of travel restrictions affecting the U.K. and Ireland goes into effect tomorrow night. Americans coming back from either country will be screened at the airport and asked to self-quarantine for 14 days. Woodman's grocery stores are limiting what customers can buy for the foreseeable future. This is the Woodman's on Madison's west side this morning. Lines out the door and fewer hours for the store. Woodman's is limiting customers to 2 paper products, 2 large cases of bottled water, and 2 cleaning products per day until further notice. President Trump says Americans do not need to be panic shopping amid the pandemic.
You don't have to buy so much. Take it easy. Just relax. People are going in and they're buying more. I remember, during the conversation, Doug of Walmart said that they're buying more than they buy at Christmas. Relax. We're doing great. It all will pass.
Walmart is shortening hours at all of its stores in response to the outbreak. The chain says the new hours will be 6 a.m. to 11 p.m. Employees will work the same schedules, but the break will give them time to restock the shelves. We know there's a lot of developing news on the coronavirus front. For the very latest information, head over to channel3000.com. Check out our coronavirus headlines section. Bernie Sanders and Joe Biden went head-to-head for the first time in a debate tonight. Their podiums were 6 feet apart from one another in an effort to promote social distancing. The debate was scheduled to be held in Arizona, but was in CNN's studio in Washington, D.C. instead, with no audience. But Biden is making headlines tonight for committing to choosing a woman as his running mate. When Sanders was asked, he also said he would, quote, in all likelihood. Next on News 3 Now at 10, with schools in our area closing, need to step in for their students. We'll show you how after the break.
Ram Truck Month means huge discounts and rebates at Don Miller. Drive in groundbreaking style. It's the new 2019 Ram 1500 Crew Cab Bighorn 4x4. Get over $11,500 in rebates and discounts on all remaining in stock. It's a 2019 IIHS top safety pick, just like the new 2019 Ram Tradesman Quad Cab 4x4. Lease for $392 per month, 48 months, 10,000 miles per year. $39.99 due at signing. Ram Truck Month is on now at Don Miller, your Madison Truck headquarters.
Don Miller.
Josh had a great smile and lots of personality, and everybody loved him. He was very sick and in the hospital for a very long time. He was just another number in that group home.
Basically, they gave him a death sentence.
The minute I met Matt, I knew that something good was going to come out of this for Josh.
And Bowler and Vaughn are great people.
To me, it doesn't seem like a law firm. It seems more like a family.
Listen, I love to grill, but we don't always have time.
Go get them.
That's when Johnsonville Flame Grilled Sausage is perfect. Tastes grilled because Johnsonville already grilled it. So you get that famous Johnsonville flavor any night of the week.
This is my best-selling Bobapedic Prize mattress. Ah, that's comfier. At $4.99 for the queen, it's the same quality of those big national brands, but for much less. It's 10 inches thick with gel-infused memory foam because comfort matters. Has a 15-year warranty and in-home trial because peace of mind matters. Ships to you in a box or set up in your home with free mattress removal because convenience matters. And available in hybrid because choice matters. Plus, a catchy jingle.
Bob's Bobapedic, from your head down to your feet. It feels like no mattress you felt before.
The all-new Silverado HD adds to the legendary capability of the strongest, most advanced Silverados ever. With best-in-class camera technology and larger, more functional beds than any competitor, the only truck that can compare to a Silverado is another Silverado.
Or get $7,000 total value on this Silverado without the optional camera technology package. Or during Truck Month, get 0% financing for 72 months plus $500 cash allowance on all Silverado 1500 Crew Cab pickups.
You make plans, what to wear, where to go, when to go, what to bring. And then the weather changes everything. Let News 3 Now First Warn Weather prepare you for what's coming. First, fast, and accurately, so you can plan your life.
Hi everyone, Monday morning we'll have the very latest on what you need to know about the coronavirus outbreak. And we'll head into the kitchen to see if buying an air fryer is worth the money. That and more local news starting at 4:30 Monday morning.
The Boys and Girls Clubs of Dane County will close tomorrow until at least April 6th. In a news conference yesterday, club officials said they raised more than $279,000 of their $300,000 goal in donations for the Dane County COVID-19 Community Emergency Fund. The fund will provide medical supplies for those impacted, meals for kids during school closures, and funds for families, college students, and senior citizens in need. With schools closing for at least 2 weeks, there are a lot of concerns about having kids at home. Melissa Kim spent a few days with teachers at one school in Madison who came up with a solution.
There's been a lot of chaos these last few days, and it's no different at Leopold Elementary Community School this Sunday morning.
All right, Annika, you're the mac and cheese queen. Thank you.
But it's a positive, organized chaos.
Dole fruit cups, one box of graham crackers.
Leopold is among the hundreds of schools in Wisconsin closing for at least 2 weeks. And while that can be scary for a lot of kids, kindergarten teacher Anna Hirsch was already thinking about what her students will eat.
I get emotional and just worry about our kids at home, and I can't even connect. Like, I can't put myself in their shoes.
Because according to Community School Resource Coordinator Rosalia Gittens, at least 80% of these kids have food insecurities. That means they get two meals a day at school.
I'm definitely worried, but at the same time, I'm really positive.
So the teachers and parents put that positivity to work, starting a GoFundMe page.
We had people donate $5. We had people donate $300. Like, and all of that added up
to more than $8,000 in less than 24 hours.
This is all the food we got with $1,700 donated.
It's amazing to be a part of groups of people who are willing to help in any way they can.
There we go.
From people not just here in Dane County, but all over the country that just wanted to help.
To see that other people and other families care about our school, even if they don't necessarily go here or are directly a part of this community, that they are a part of this community.
That community includes kids as young as 6. A small reminder that in these trying times, we need to help our friends.
A lot of people don't have food and they need it.
I want to help out the families that are in need and just do as much as possible as I can.
If I don't help my friends, that would kind of be bad.
As of tonight, 54 families got bags of food to help ease the stress of the next few weeks, and teachers are hoping to continue to raise money to keep them fed after the 2 weeks are over. If you want to help, we put a link on our website. This past week has shown how serious the coronavirus is and how it's seriously impacted people's mental health. A psychologist we spoke with at UW Health says that the more stress we're under, the weaker our immune systems become. They recommended meditating or reaching out to a counselor who may be able to offer counseling through video chat. They say limit your social media exposure and check the news once a day for no more than 30 minutes. Anytime you become stressed about bad news, pair it with two things you're grateful for. They said there are ways to turn your negatives into positives.
Silver lining here for everyone. We sometimes have to search for it. So instead, focus on the opportunities, like maybe I get to connect with new people I never would have met through this experience. And maybe I can help somebody, like my neighbor, bringing them groceries or flowers. Or maybe I can call somebody who's struggling. Or maybe I just get to spend more time with my kids.
She also said, you decide what your mind will focus on during this time. Use this opportunity to maximize your time at home. That way, it doesn't feel like so much of a loss. Let's get a look at your first warm weather with meteorologist Dana Fulton. I mean, some positive things. We've got some sunshine. Spring is almost here,
and we have some milder weather. Overall, things have been behaving pretty nicely for us in the weather corner. We're going to continue to see temperatures creep up just a little bit over the next few days. Today, we were pretty close to average for our afternoon highs. And as we look ahead through the next few days, we'll see temperatures climb not only above average, but they're going to stay there. We'll steadily creep back into the low 50s. If we could get Max 1 into the computer, that would be fantastic. If not, I can continue to talk about the mild temperatures creeping on up for us. Over the next few days, we'll see our temperatures increase. St. Patrick's Day is on Tuesday. There we go. Before I had to go through all of the calendar. Mostly cloudy skies on Monday. Milder temperatures expected. And then showers and thunderstorms will be building in for the end of the week, just in time for the first day of spring. So that's really going to line up again with what we expect to see as we get towards the end of March. Officially the first day of spring, only 4 days away on Thursday, so just around the corner. We had a pretty quiet day today with high pressure to the north and the shower chances well down to the south. If you were looking for any heavy rain down into Texas. Some light rain and light snow off into the Pacific Northwest. That system is going to continue to stay in the Northwest. It'll start to move closer to us as we get towards the end of the week. Overnight, our skies are going to become mostly cloudy. We'll start off Monday with a mostly cloudy sky, and then in the afternoon, high temperatures will be in the mid to upper 40s with that breeze coming from the southwest. The chance of rain overnight from Monday into Tuesday is very, very slim, but we could see some light isolated showers. Some folks might wake up with just a few raindrops on the windshield. Heading into Tuesday, we get clearing skies. That means partly sunny skies for Tuesday with temperatures climbing in the afternoon into the mid 40s again. So it should be quite a pleasant afternoon outside. High pressure building in. You can see right there that a rotation of our winds moving clockwise. That's the center of the high passing right on over, and that's going to keep things pretty quiet for our Tuesday. Rain chances develop on Wednesday passing on through, and that's going to bring some heavier rain at times, but we get a break in the rain before another chance for showers will build on in as we get into Thursday and Friday. Our temperature trend likely going to stay fairly close to average for most of the Midwest. We might see a little bit of a drop as we get in that 6 to 10 day outlook, but tomorrow we're above average. Average for this time of year is about 43, so 47 is a good spot. Variably cloudy skies and just a little milder outside. A little more mild. We'll see temperatures in the mid to upper 40s for Monday and Tuesday. Again, Tuesday is St. Patrick's Day, so here's your reminder to make sure you have your green on hand. A chance for showers building in on Wednesday. It may mix with just a little bit of snow at night before coming to an end, and then our second round of rain and snow develops for Thursday and Friday. Spring is Thursday. The first day of spring is Thursday, so we could have a few isolated thunderstorms lining right up with the first day of spring. A break for the weekend with another chance for rain, it seems like, developing as we head into next week. But mild temperatures, no big jumps or drops with our temperatures, and really no severe weather on the way. Even with the chance for a few isolated thunderstorms, things are continuing to stay very lamb-like for March. We haven't had any lion moments yet.
And we're right in the middle, so good trend.
We've had a good half so far, and looking ahead and forecasting, we're in a pretty good spot, I think, for the next week.
All right, thank you so much, Dana. Still ahead on News 3 Now at 10, we're on day 4 of no major sporting events in the world, but that means we're learning about some other sports. Highlights next.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
The all-new Silverado HD adds to the legendary capability of the strongest, most advanced Silverados ever. With best-in-class camera technology and larger, more functional beds than any competitor, the only truck that can compare to a Silverado is another Silverado.
Or get $7,000 total value on this Silverado without the optional camera technology package. Or during truck month, get 0% financing for 72 months plus $500 cash allowance on all Silverado 1500 crew cab pickups.
You wouldn't accept an incomplete job from anyone else, so why accept it from your allergy pills? Flonase relieves your worst symptoms, which most pills don't. Get all-in-one allergy relief for 24 hours with Flonase.
It's starting.
Selection, price, and speed. Nobody beats us, guaranteed. Two complete pairs start under $40. Two pairs with Progressive start under $80.
That was epic. Ugh.
Right glasses.
Right, right.
Right now.
At U.S. Cellular, we're building a powerful new 5G network that breaks down barriers. Because it's only fair that you get uninterrupted service, so you can work without obstacles. And stream without disruptions. 5G, now available in Wisconsin. Unlimited data starts at $30 a month. It's the best value in wireless. Switch today for just $30 a month with 4 lines. U.S. Cellular. Choose fair.
So I just got the PF Black Card for no enrollment fee.
Really?
Yeah, I get all the perks.
Like what?
Like a free guest.
Hey, Carl.
And I can work out at any Planet Fitness anywhere. Like while I was just on vacation.
Aloha.
Wow.
And massage chairs. I'm in.
Yeah, she is.
Get it all with the PF Black Card. Zero down, $22.99 a month. Deal ends March 16th.
5 Madison area locations. Offer expires March 16th. Stop in and see us today.
Okay, in my Johnsonville commercial, they open on a game show set in the 70s. Today we got Johnsonville smoked sausage made with 100% premium pork. Some brands mix meats and add fillers, but not Johnsonville.
Contestant number one bids the closest, so he wins a boat. And he says, I don't want that boat. I want the sausage. What if I told you that boat is filled with Johnsonville smoked sausage? And that's a smoked sausage commercial made the Johnsonville way.
While you're out there, living life to its fullest, living every day like it's your last, seizing the days or carpeing the diems, just remember, you only need one Jeep Renegade. Because when you're a part of the longest-lasting 4x4 SUV brand, you're ready to celebrate every moment.
During the Jeep Celebration event, well-qualified returning lessees can lease the 2020 Renegade Latitude 4x4 for $179 a month.
Does go on even without practices or games, and people can, you know, they can still communicate by phone and email. So NFL players voting to approve a new collective bargaining agreement with league owners today. It will last until at least the year 2030. Now, among the things passed, a 17-game regular season as early as next season, and the playoff field will be expanded from 12 teams to 14 as soon as this upcoming season. But some players not in favor of it as a whole, including Aaron Rodgers. He's been very outspoken about it, and also his teammates like Tremont Williams, tweeting this statement earlier today. And David Bakhtiari also chiming in, basically saying that the new CBA doesn't look to the big picture or to the future. Some good news for the Brewers. No one on the team has tested positive for COVID-19. General Manager David Stearns told reporters that today, and he also said the team is split into thirds right now, physically speaking, with a third of them still in Arizona, a third of them in Milwaukee, and a third of them at their respective homes with their families. Opening day still looking at a two-week delay at the very least. Some basketball news today was supposed to be Selection Sunday, I know, but in the NBA, owners and execs are looking at what they can do for a best-case scenario. That means games will start again in mid to late June, but without any fans. They are currently scouting dates for arenas all the way through August. Yesterday, UFC in Brazil was the only major sporting event in the world actually taking place. Today, we've got PBA World Championship Bowling. That is professional bowling in Las Vegas. The event limited to close family and essential personnel, as you can see there. Jason Belmonte winning his 13th major title by beating Anthony Simonson. Now, if you are missing sports, the major sports in general, this could be a good opportunity to learn about some sports that you don't really know of much about. Gary Kenalty is very much a bowling enthusiast, something that I don't know a whole lot about. But it's a time to, you know, maybe check out some Formula One racing, some, I don't know, whatever sport that you think that you don't know a lot about. We're learning opportunities here,
guys. And there are some sports still out there that you can watch, so.
Correct.
Learn something new.
Yes, exactly.
Learn how to bowl.
More about learning.
We'll be right back.
Volkswagen's list of standard features goes on and on, but this event won't. Hurry in during the not-so-standard spring event, and you can lease a new 2020 Tiguan. Zero down, zero deposit, zero first month payment, and zero to its signing. Practically just sign, then drive.
Winter in Wisconsin means snow, blustering winds, and sub-zero temperatures. Will your insulation keep your home warm? Frank Construction can always help. We're your roofing and insulation pros. We'll find cracks at air pathways in your insulation that are letting in the icy cold and hindering your comfort. With our thermal imaging and cutting-edge insulation techniques, you'll be sure that your home will be warm and energy efficient for many years to come. Visit frankconstruction.com today and prepare your home for the long winter.
Since you were 8 policy from American Family Insurance. Insure carefully. Dream fearlessly.
Meet Jim. For Jim, comfort is king. Which is why when it comes to his dentures, only new PolyGrip Cushion and Comfort will do. The first and only formula with adaptive grip cushioning technology. Choose new PolyGrip Cushion and Comfort.
Food you love doesn't love you back. Stay smooth and fight heartburn fast with Tums Smoothies.
Back by popular demand at Slumberland. Look at what just $10 a month will get you when you spend $5.99. Our lowest finance offer ever. But act fast. It won't last long. Pay no interest for 5 years when you spend $5.99 or more. A classy bedroom set, all four pieces, only $10 a month. A mattress with upholstered base, $10 a month. 5 year financing on purchases of just $5.99 or more. And get free shipping with no minimum, and most items can be in your home in a week. Only at Slumberland Furniture.
Wow, you ready?
Yeah, let me just grab my wallet.
Uh-oh, I've seen this before. Wallet way too big, skinny jeans too skinny.
I'll just carry it.
Before you break something, you should know you don't actually need a wallet. With BMO Harris, you can just take cash out with your phone. Or if you need to, you can pay them with Zelle.
That works?
Yeah. You're stuck, aren't you?
Smile.
Those jeans are way too tight.
That feeling you get when no wallet is no big deal. That's the BMO effect.
Can you throw in 2 years of the carefree scheduled maintenance, the turbocharged engine,
and smartphone integration?
Yep, all comes standard.
Hurry in during the not-so-standard spring event, and you can lease a new 2020 Tiguan. Zero down, zero deposit, zero first month's payment, and zero to its signing. Practically just sign, then drive.
Get the facts with Reality Check, only on News 3 Now.
Temperatures will be in the mid to upper 40s tomorrow with variably cloudy skies. Partly sunny on St. Patrick's Day with shower chances on Wednesday. We'll see showers and thunderstorms on Thursday for the first day of spring and sunshine for next weekend.
All right. Thanks so much for joining us. Have a great night.